In this video, I talk about boundaries, the importance of boundaries and how we can set boundaries in our lives, in our friendships, in dating, in marriage, and even in academics. So here we go. Hello to you, my wonderful viewer, and welcome back to my channel. My name is Judyowiti, and I pray that you've been keeping well. And if you're new here, karibu sana, and please subscribe. Now, do you know what this is called? It's called a guardrail. A guardrail is designed to keep vehicles from straying into dangerous or off-limit areas. You find them on bridges, in medians where we are close to cars moving in the opposite direction, and around sharp curves or cliffs. Guardrails protect us from what's on the other side, the danger zone. So the idea behind the guardrail is that there'll be less damage on you or your car if you hit the guardrail than if you actually hit what was on the other side of the guardrail. So that in case there was no guardrail, then the results would be disastrous. Now, the principle of the guardrail applies in life too. Personal guardrails can be a standard by which you live your life. It can also be a person. A guardrail can also be a person that helps you stay on track. Now, you and I, if we look back on our lives, the bad decisions that we regret were as a result of our failure to put guardrails in place. Now, we see people every day wreck their lives, destroy their careers, destroy their reputation, lose their families, lose their marriages, get in debt as they live beyond their means. All this because they have failed to put guardrails in these areas of their lives. So, what if we had guardrails in our relationships, in dating, in marriage, in our finances, in business, in our academics? It's really about wanting what you know is God's will for your life, and therefore putting in place guardrails so that that will comes to be. Ephesians 5:15-16 says, "Be very careful then how you live, not as unwise, but as wise, making the most of every opportunity, because the days are evil." Let us look at examples, and the first one is friendship. Now, we all have a story of when we got around someone who was moving in the opposite direction, you know, and you got closer and closer and closer, and we are the ones that changed directions. They led us astray because they had different morals and values. The thing is that our friends influence and sometimes determine the quality and the direction of our lives. Just like when you are on the road, on the highway, and you have this oncoming traffic and you don't want to get too close to it, because if it gets close to you, you get damaged. So in the same way, these friends who are moving in the opposite direction are going to damage you, and you just have to put guardrails so that you're not close to them. And this is how you know you're with the wrong group of people. You pretend to be somebody other than who you really are. You really try to fit in. You even ignore your values. You compromise who you are. You don't want your family to find out that you've been with these people. Those are red flags. That's your conscience telling you that there's something wrong here. So here are the guardrails. Don't ignore the wisdom of your parents when they tell you or they warn you about a particular friendship. Listen to their guidance. They know better. Another guardrail can be a community group. For example, like a life group, a Bible study, a book club, a master class. These are people who are moving hopefully in the same direction that you are headed, and they are able to give you support. The third guardrail is a mentor. Find a mentor. A mentor is so important because they will keep you accountable. They will hold your hand. They will walk with you and help you with the issues of life. The other area is in the area of relationships, in terms of dating and marriage. A lot of the issues that you find in relationships, and the ones that we keep having over and over again, are really as a result of us failing to create boundaries in the first place. in a dating scenario, you need to have a standard, you know, a set of values that you say, you know what, I need to see these values in this person. And if I don't see these values, then you're not moving forward. You know, you need to set a standard of how you want to be treated. For example, that someone should not be verbally abusive, physically abusive towards you. And if they are, then you run. You know that, okay, this is not the right relationship for me, and you run. Or you have made a decision that in this dating process, we are not going to have sex before marriage, you're going to remain pure. And then you go ahead and ask questions like, oh, but how far should we go? The Bible is very clear. It says flee from sexual immorality. It means it doesn't say stroll, it doesn't say walk, it says flee. It's not automatic. That means you need to put a guardrail in place. And so you can say, you know what, there are no sleepovers. I will not be coming to your place at night, or I will not be alone with you in your house. And for the married, it usually starts out very innocent. You know, you are confiding in this single co-worker, and it's very dangerous because your emotional world get intertwined. And, you know, intimacy does not begin with the physical. Intimacy begins with the emotional. And so be very careful and know the right person to confide in. The Bible says that the prudent see danger and they take refuge, but the simple keep going and they suffer for it. The prudent see danger in having coffee alone with him and they say no, or having coffee with her alone and they say no. In terms of work-life balance, you know, decide, I need to be home by this time. And when I'm home, I need to be present. You know, I need to be present for my wife. I need to be present for my husband. I need to be present for my children. It's possible to have a successful career and lose your family. Another area is finances. Now, this is a big one. This is a big one. Know where your money is going. You know, track your expenses, learn to make a budget and stick to it. Avoid the temptation of living beyond your means. You know, stop keeping up with the Joneses. Because at the end of the day, when you get in debt, you're the only person who will suffer. So your guardrail becomes that budget, you know, because you're able to track your expenses. You're able to know where your money is going. You're able to live within your means. Academics. You don't want to study, but you want an A. And so you have found a way to make an A without studying. You are either cheating in your exams or you're sleeping with your lecturer so you can get an A. Listen, you're laying down a foundation that is very shaky and it will work against you. You need a guardrail. So put together a schedule or a timetable that works, you know. Let it have more time for work and less time for leisure, because, you know, there is time for everything. And this is a time that you need to be working hard to get good grades. If you're struggling in an assignment or you're struggling in a subject, get a colleague that understands that subject better. And let them take you through it, or ask your professor in advance in terms of, explain to me further so that I can understand better. And you'll find that you'll be able to do well. And the last one is social media. You know, we need to be very careful about social media, because garbage in, garbage out. Second, the time that we are wasting on social media, it means that something is suffering. It could be our family is suffering. It could be our work is suffering. And we'll not be able to achieve the things that God has for us if we are busy spending so much time just on social media, wasting time. So what do? Let's put a guardrail and say, I can only spend this amount of time in a day on social media. And you make sure that you follow through. Nowadays, we even have apps that monitor how long you are on social media, and they are able to notify you. Decide the kind of activities that you're going to do there. Don't go to social media to troll people, to throw negative vibes all over the place, you know, just criticizing everybody all over the place. Follow people that are positive, follow people that inspire you and give you wisdom for your life. Now, having said all that, I want to say this, that guardrails are set intentionally and on purpose. You have to be very intentional about setting them. And we have a very good example in the Bible of somebody who was very purposeful, somebody who intentionally set a guardrail, and his name is Daniel. In Daniel 1:8, it says, "But Daniel purposed in his heart that he would not defile himself with the portion of the king's delicacies, nor with the wine which he drank. Therefore he requested of the chief of the eunuchs that he might not defile himself. Now here's the thing. Daniel was a teenage boy when he was taken into captivity in Babylon. And he could have decided, you know what, this food looks good, my parents are not here, I don't have to uphold the Jewish laws of what I should eat and what I should not eat. But Daniel kind of just decided that I am not going to cross that line. And because of this decision that he makes, we see God directing his entire life, and we just see him being so successful in serving different governments that came after that. Like Daniel, we need to be able to draw a line and say, we will not cross this line. Well, I have a question for you. Where do you need guardrails in your life? Who do you need to invite into your life to act as a guardrail? Because for you to be able to get a hold of the things that God has for you, you will need to put guardrails in place. That is all for today. Stay safe. God bless you. And I will see you next time.